What's up, gamers? DreamcastGuy here, talking today about Samurai Jack Battle Through Time. But this video is going to be a little bit unusual. So typically, before I review a game, I try and do a bunch of research. I want to try and investigate stuff like the development, the series, the franchise itself, to see what the game is going to be before I even have a chance to pick up the controller. But with this game, I decided to do something very different, which is that I have made a conscious decision not to go back and watch the original cartoon. Now, honestly, I did grow up watching it. I enjoyed the Samurai Jack of old. It was a very, very cool show when I was growing up, but I wanted to play this game and see how it stands on its own. Can this actually be a very fun adventure, even if you don't remember every single villain, side episode, and random adventure that happened with Samurai Jack back in the day? And let me just tell you right up front, this game is shockingly high quality. It is a really good little experience, and I think that it really manages to work, even if you don't remember everything about Samurai Jack. Now, just to get you up to speed, this is a very, very straightforward story. Basically, Samurai Jack is the main character, he is a master swordsman, and he has a giant vendetta against the demon Aku, which is this big, spooky-looking creature. This demon is practically a dark god. Not only is he able to warp reality and have millions of minions, he has the powers over time and space, which makes defeating him a pretty difficult task. So basically in this game, you get sent through a hole in time that is outside the boundaries of typical space. And this is kind of just an excuse that means that we're going to be fighting through a bunch of very cool levels that don't really connect. You're kind of just fighting from one spot to another, taking on zombies and giants and all sorts of different cool mummies and stuff, and then suddenly it'll just teleport you to the next environment and have you fighting more stuff. And I have to say, this definitely works because the glue that holds it together is the really cool retro-inspired combat. Now, if you're somebody that actually had something like a GameCube or an original Xbox when you were like a kid, this, it really kind of reminds me of those style of games, those really early 3D hack and slashers. Now, at the start of the game, things are very, very basic. I would say they are extremely simplistic because towards the start, you only have a basic thing, which is strong attack and fast attack and your standard sword in your hand. But as you progress, slowly, just by finding different treasure chests and disarming enemies, you get a huge set of weaponry, from heavy clubs that are covered in spikes, giant hammers that can actually knock people off balance, bows, mighty spears, and even stuff like guns. Because yes, since this is Samurai Jack, you're not only going to the ancient past, you're also being flung into the far future, and so you do get a chance to pick up a freaking machine gun and blast people with stuff. And I have to say that why this really is good is because as you're going through the game, you really kind of get a chance to tinker with how you want to take down each of the different enemies and their different weaknesses. Every level, this is by far my favorite thing, I'll just say right here, my favorite thing about the game is that every level has its own set of bad guys. There's this own special theme to it, and it totally sticks to it. So if you're in like an area of evil ninjas, you're going to be fighting these evil ninjas that are throwing samurai stars at you and stuff. And once you're taking out kunai, then you have a chance to try and fight back. Everybody needs to be taken down though in their own particular way, whether it be counterattacks. Some people actually are weak to being shot in the face, so you can save bullets for that. And there's all sorts of big cool boss fights, and none of it ever feels redone. Occasionally you will see an enemy from like level 4 pop up in level 9, but you never feel like they're just doing stuff to try and remix it for the sake of laziness. Now, I do want to talk about something that's very strange in this game, is that there are sections that are very, very 3D. There's parts where you're going to be jumping on top of ledges, finding all sorts of cool secrets, trying to duck and dodge and find new unlockables, but there's also some sections that are actually like a 2D beat-em-up. There's really these parts where the game is stuck 2D. This like looks 3D right here. It is not. I can only press press left and right, pressing up and down does absolutely nothing. These side-scrolling sections are kind of the way of getting you across big parts of the map quickly. Like if they're trying to find a way to get you from one part of the town to another part of the town, maybe they'll do something like give you a straight path that's a side-scroller for a second. And these parts, they work, but they definitely feel like maybe they ran out of budget while they were working on this game, and this was their easy solution. It's not necessarily bad, but it definitely feels so drastically peculiar according to the rest of the game, which is much more opened up. Now, something in this game that's definitely cool is the fact that there is just so much hidden stuff. There are a lot of different collectibles that can just be found. There's all sorts of, like, hidden runes that can make you actually level up quicker. There's extra powerful weapons that can be found. But while you're grinding, this does bring me to something in the game that I consider the biggest drawback, which is you're going to be finding a lot of different currencies. There is a lot of stuff like the upgrade trees, which I want to talk about in a second, but you're going to be finding a lot of gold. Apparently, Samurai Jack is surprisingly rich for a guy that's not really stuck in any particular time period, but there's something in this game that completely drives me nuts. For some reason, there is weapon degradation. I don't know why it is that game developers a couple years ago decided that if your weapons break, it's suddenly cool. This is really dumb, but what happens in this game is occasionally, as you're exploring, you'll find this guy who can upgrade your particular weapons, making it so you're better with hammers or, you know, heavy clubs, or personally what I love the most is just upgrading my basic sword. But you do need to also spend your gold specifically on repairing your equipment. You can actually have your stuff permanently shatter. Now, your main sword is invincible. It's magic. It's totally fine. But it kind of drove me nuts that as I was going through this game, it was annoying to me that if stuff broke, it just got deleted, which meant that sometimes the best weapons, the things that I really enjoyed the most, I was so afraid of them breaking that I just saved them for the biggest, baddest bosses. And this also made it where I end up spending so much of my money just trying to repair my guns because they're breaking down from being shot. I hate that I had to actually use my gold for either upgrades or repairs. I think that they should try and remove this, or at least make repairs much, much cheaper, because the upgrades in this game feel really good. Now, the other thing that's in this game is definitely the skill trees. Defeating enemies gives you special experience points, and then you can do this to upgrade passive bonuses, like are basically things like extra ways of getting even more currency when you get kills, special extra high jumps, or there can be more active upgrades, like new kill combos, or a special way to actually disarm people and rip the weapon out of their hands. All the skill trees are pretty good, but honestly, it feels like the passive bonuses are way better. Like, I just feel like being able to reduce every bit of damage taken by a huge degree, this feels way stronger. There's definitely not a big amount of balance, but I guess it doesn't have to be. This game isn't really concerned with being a big budget AAA release. It's fine being a cool little indie style game, or at least that's what it feels like. But that's also why it's also just so charming. Now, the last thing I do want to warn you about is that I did have some technical issues. There was some pretty heavy frame rate dips. Not all the time, but in the later levels, they definitely bombard you with a lot more enemies. There's also like flying foes and stuff. At this point, you have a huge selection of weapons, and usually by this point, you also have a lot of different weapon upgrades, so they really try and stack people on your face. And it doesn't seem like the game is able to handle that. Now, all of this is being recorded on my PlayStation 4 Pro, and even my Pro was really kind of getting bogged down at times with trying to have a bunch of different objects smashable and having all these objects each trying to do their own individual thing. It's not necessarily bad, but it definitely seems like this was maybe needing just a little bit more tuning up, and I am a little bit concerned with how this may run on lower powered systems. With that being said, I really got blown away by how good Samurai Jack was. Battle Through Time is an interesting little gem, and even if you only know just the loosest amount about this game, if you're only just very vaguely familiar with who Samurai Jack and Aku is, this is easily a very good weekend adventure that I'm very glad I had a chance to beat. Okay, so we've heard a lot of good and a little bit of bad, but let's go over the ratings board and put a big number on it. I am giving Samurai Jack Battle Through Time an 8 out of 10. If you've been finding yourself itching for some really old school fun, something that's not going to be super complex or have like 500 different styles of combo points, this is a game that's fun, it's very, very straightforward, and it's a game that just feels so nice to sit down with and chop up some heads and stuff. So seriously, give it a shot. If you're into Samurai Jack, you are going to be extremely pleased. Thanks so much for watching, gamers. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, share with your friends, and subscribe if you haven't already. But do me the biggest favor of all, and keep dreaming. Oh, my voice cracked a little bit. Man, I've been yelling about Samurai Jack for so long now. This is so cool. Huge, huge props to Adult Swim Games. This is a really freaking good little project. Thanks so much for watching that video. If you want to see something else, you can always click this link to see what I put up last, or, you know, subscribe and see what's coming up next. Also, I promise that whatever I do, it'll try not to suck.